Have you ever heard Birds of Paradise? This is an armed youth wing of children under age 14. I know you are aware with human rights violations, but the bitter depth is brutally grim, gray and grave. The name of this grave is Area of Conflict, where all kind of abductions and assaults, violations and exploitations, slavery and sufferings, maiming and killing is just like a mandatory part of a daily life. Their homes burned, families killed, innocence stolen. I'm talking about the war on children. Their schools, playgrounds, and hospitals are turned into the fields of battle. Childhood and innocence of untold millions torn apart in conflict-related violence. Education, livelihood, moral, ethics eliminated from their life. For them, these are unknown words of some alien language. Either they are not from the same earth, or maybe they are not the children of human. The number of children living in the conflict areas increased by 300% in just last one decade, and intensity of violations and violence equally increased. The psychological impact of the toxic stress and trauma of violence on the mental health of these children, having lifelong, far-reaching, cruel consequences. We are leaving next generations in the endless struggle to turn back the tide of brutality and to rebuild the peaceful lives and societies. The nature of the modern conflict is extremely complex and devastating. Often seems this is an organized, deliberate and systematic intense violence on the name of state-based conflict, interstate conflict, non-state conflict, political conflict, regional conflict, and even the religious conflict. Are the big names and the powers being for nothing, or do they have the contribution and share in these conflicts? Children are the major victims and the cheapest fuel of such international conflicts. An armed forces group recruited roughly more than 40,000 children between only 2005 to 2016. These are underreported numbers. The actual is hell. How harsh to feel if it is a part of political, social, and economic developments. How guilty to feel if it is a deliberate agenda, tactic, strategy, or policy of the world powers. How shameful to feel 370 million children not lost only their childhood, but in fact everything, with lifetime bleeding of pain. How blank to feel human without humanity. Children are the 16% of the world population, and one of the six children living in the conflict areas. That means every sixth child living at risk, especially from the last three decades, opening eyes in the violence, recruited like nothing and killed like never born. Children are the major victims, from occupied Kashmir to Afghanistan, from Iraq to Syria, from Somalia to Sudan, and from Colombia to Congo, from Myanmar to Yemen and Nigeria to the Central African Republic. In conflicting areas, children face an extreme physical, psychological and social violence. Even more than a football got kicked and rolled in a full-length intense soccer match. Thousands of such brutal matches got played in these conflicting areas on daily basis. Under such devastating crisis, many of these areas are facing access denial for humanitarian aid and right to survive. The exact picture of destructive impact of armed conflicted area is horribly hard to draw. The international bodies and laws need an urgent collective action to overcome the crisis of human compliance more than ever. What are we really leaving for our next generations? Let's do something for the victims, to prevent, to protect, and to end the war on children and rebuild the shattered lives. Believe in humanity and growth for all. Standing aside is no longer an option. Join our voice to reach the world leaders. I wish and pray suffering of conflict ends soon.